Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making fried bacon and sawmill gravy. Let me show you the bacon that I'm going to use. I've already opened this one. This is original country bacon, and it comes from Browning's Country Ham. And I've mentioned that before because we got our country ham for Easter from there. And here are some examples of bacons you can get. And since I have used this a couple times, I am going to put a link down below the video so you could check it out if you want to get the same kind. But this is peppered country bacon, and this one is applewood smoked bacon. So there are different varieties, and they even have thick sliced bacon if you want to use that. But I'm choosing to use the original this time, and I'll use the other pounds of bacon for other purposes. These are in 1 pound sizes that I'm showing you. I have my big cast iron skillet over here, and I have the burner turned on just for a couple of minutes, but it should be heating up. So I'm going to start putting the slices of bacon in, and I'll keep it heating until it gets to the point where it's maybe sizzling a little too much. But now there's very little sizzle. I'll probably put half of this if I can fit it in, or a third, and then come back for other batches and finish it, and you'll see what it looks like when it's fried. And I will tend it a little bit. I will use a fork and just push it around in the bacon grease that comes up, and it doesn't actually need turning, but if it looks like it would benefit from turning, I will do that. So I basically will just be here watching the progress to make sure that nothing goes awry. I'm getting the last few pieces of crisp bacon out of the grease that it has made, and sometimes there will be some strips that are a little thicker than others, so those are the last ones that come out. But here we have our pound of bacon all fried up and nice and crispy. This is the way I like it. If you don't like it this crisp, then just take it up a little earlier. And I did stand here and tend it, and I did turn several times each piece because they got brown on the bottom side, or were brownish on the bottom side, and needed to be turned over to be brown all the way through. Most of you know, if you've watched for a long time, that I generally bake bacon instead of frying it at the stove. But I plan to use the grease that has come up here, because the next step that we're going to do today is to make sawmill gravy. I've placed my bacon over on the counter, and we'll get to that later, but first we're going to make gravy. This is sawmill gravy, and it's made from bacon drippings. I have poured off this much pure grease, so there is grease left, but there's this lovely fond in the bottom, and that's what's going to make this into a brown gravy. We're starting by using some flour, and actually I've heated this. I'm going to turn it off now because I see a little smoke coming up. But we're going to add some flour, about a half cup. This happens to be 3/4 cup, so I'm not going to put all of it in at the very beginning. But just stir that flour around and add more as needed. I think I'll need all of that for what I have. And cook that until it is the color of peanut butter. So it needs to be brownish, but a little on the tan side, and it needs to be cooked thoroughly. I have cooked and stirred this roux for about 10 minutes. And you can see the color is darkened, it's a light brown, and it is thick enough that we can go ahead with our recipe. The next thing we do is add milk. So I have milk measured out. Here we have 2 cups. I'm just going to pour some in and stir and just see how this reacts together. Continue to add milk and stir over low heat. And I'll put all of this in. This was 2 cups. So I'm going to work on this for a while, and I may need to add more milk. We'll see, and I'll tell you when I come back. Here is our sawmill gravy, and that's after continually stirring and adding another cup of milk. So we have 3 cups of milk in here that were necessary in order to make it the right texture. And you can make it thinner if you want to put more milk in it. So we're ready to season it. It definitely needs to be salted, and if you like pepper, you need to put that in at this point. So I'm just sprinkling some salt in, but you'll do this to taste, so you may want to actually taste of it at this point. I'm just guessing. And then we'll stir that in, and we'll be ready to take it over to the counter and pour it into a nice serving bowl. Here is our sawmill gravy right after pouring it into this container, and I'll be serving it with this large spoon. Over here to the left, or my left, you can see the nice slices of bacon. They're all crisp, but they could be half and half, or they could all be less crisp than that. Over here, I have a bacon candle, in case you've never heard of one of those. You know from past experience in Betty's Kitchen that I love bacon. Here we have cat head biscuits that we made on a recent upload, and that's what I'm going to use as the basis for the gravy. So I've got some hot biscuits right here in the plate, along with about 4 strips of bacon. We're going to slice the biscuits open, and then I'm going to bring this over so I can dip some of this lovely sawmill gravy over the top. Now, this is an old-time recipe, so if you've never heard of it, I wouldn't be surprised. I'm going to take a taste of this for you and let you know what I think. I'm not going to do the bacon because I know it's just wonderful, and bacon is a favorite of mine. I'm going to save that for in a few minutes. But here, we're going to get into the cat head biscuit that's topped with sawmill gravy. Doesn't that look good? I got the salt just right. It's the first thing I could taste was just a faint taste of salt. And it's nice and bacony. I love it. I hope you enjoyed it.